cute. She's funny.
She's reliable.
We all love the internet. But just like my last relationship, I find myself asking important questions like, where's this thing going? And will there always be memes? Okay, well, that last one doesn't fit, but you get my drift. Let's get to the question. It seems like we're stuck in an endless loop of making new accounts online. Will the internet ever change? I'll keep it real. It's impossible to remember all the passwords for all the accounts we have to make. They gotta be 20 plus characters long, include symbols, emojis, your blood type, and a DNA sample? Okay, it's too much. It's too much! Passwords also create a single point of failure in a security chain, which sucks. We still use them though, and that's because change is hard. Most people have been using the same weak password for years. Let's play a little game. I'm gonna list off the top 10 passwords used on the internet, which are also listed in one of the many lists of common passwords that are used to crack accounts. If you use one of the passwords in this top 10 list, then you win a free trip to Change Your Password Island! That's right, folks, this trip is an all-expense paid and completely made up. You'll have the luxury of sitting on your couch at home and changing your password immediately. All right, folks, now for the passwords themselves. Coming in at number 10, football. Great one. At number 9, baseball. Number 8, oh, wait, we can't say that, you little nasty. Number 7 is dragon. Well, at least it's not. At number 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we're getting to the good ones. Number 5, Qwerty. You can't make these up if you even tried. The numbers 4, 3, and 2 are just variations of number 6. I never said that these were creative. Don't at me. Finally, our number 1 most used password. Can I get a drum roll, please? That's right, folks. It is password. If you're using password as your password in 2023, you should probably just quit the internet now. If you're still here, then great. You're using a strong password. Pat yourself on the back. I'm proud of you. And if you want to dig in more, we did a whole episode about passwords, so make sure you check that out. Why is this still here? All right, you got your strong password, but that doesn't mean you're safe. Passwords are flawed. Even the strongest passwords can be cracked. And that's where the Fast Identity Online Alliance steps in. They're like the Avengers for passwords. Fido assemble! So the Fido Alliance wants to change the game for this login nightmare, and their plans run deeper than just juicing up our old password game. According to Fido, over 80% of corporate data breaches are caused by weak or stolen passwords. To fix this outdated issue, Fido is developing a system of universal passkeys, like your fingerprint, to simplify and strengthen our logins. Get pumped for a passwordless future! If you want to know more about Fido, take a look at their website on FidoAlliance.org to learn more about their mission, who they are, and why it's important that we ditch passwords. Next question. Will I be able to actually surf the web like a wave one day? I can't swim. We're living through some very exciting times. VR is blossoming after surviving the failure of Virtual Boy. Social media is evolving in new and interesting ways. And work has made its way out of the office and into our homes. You can wear your PJs. The sky's the limit for what's to come. But there are some who have an idea of where things are going. VR hardware is getting more advanced every day. And it's not just for video games or social media apps. Augmented reality features are being rolled out more and more, turning your living room into a playground for your imagination or into a conference room, which is way less fun. They're even gaining more traction in education, from virtual museum visits to medical students training for surgery. Looking outside the headset, there are incredible advances in hand tracking and haptic feedback coming. And some people are even taking it upon themselves to design hand tracking devices you can 3D print at home for less than 100 bucks. I've got one. I made this coaster. For those who really want to feel virtual reality, there are even full body suits with haptic feedback. In its current state, you're spending upwards of $10,000 on a scuba suit that tases you. And who would want that? Woo-wee! VR is getting bananas! Right now it's a little gimmicky, like fighting off zombies and whatnot. But in a few years' time, we may be able to feel the digital wind through our hair. Ooh. Last question. But what about right now? Isn't the internet just fine how it is? I don't need all that fancy schmancy cyber trash. Yeah, The internet is just fine. If you don't mind scrolling, clicking, tapping, and clicking. But for those people out there who can't see what they're scrolling or hear what they're watching or even hold a phone to begin with, the current state of the internet isn't as accessible to them. After all, the internet is a place for everyone. And for Mozilla, the future of the internet lies in expanding that accessibility. Auto-generated captions and alternative text are incredible tools for making any video watchable to the hard of hearing or seeing. And they're getting better every day.
Ordering butter.
I said they're getting better every day.
Ordering butter.
Better, not butter.
Ordering butter.
Okay, fine. They're getting butter every day. Pete's sake. Mozilla's always cooking up some incredible stuff in the kitchen realm of language accessibility. You see what I did there? Cooking up with the butter. You gotta make do with what you're given. Common Voice makes it possible for language communities around the world to tap into speech recognition technology. With new languages added every year, we're creating a more open and accessible AI ecosystem. The internet is an incredible place and should be available to everyone, no matter how or where they came up. Well, that's gonna be it for today's episode. I'm gonna miss you. Think you know what the internet is gonna be like in 10 years? Tell us in the comments. Would you wanna talk to aliens if you had the choice? Wanna know more? Drop your questions in the comments or find us on Twitter and Instagram at Firefox. While we're waiting here, here are a few of my favorite passwords. Shadow. Ooh, that's edgy. Computer. I guess that's easy to remember. Peanut butter. Backpack. Dookie booty.